with Evelyn. I'm late for dinner. It's the first time the whole family has been back together since my brother Walter got back from Shanghai, and typically I am late. I'm sorry, Mav. Things just got a little behind schedule with the union. Fav is at the head of the table with Mav to his right and Walter to his left. Walter's my favourite brother, but don't tell Alf or Henry. Next to Walter is Alf. I'm surprised he managed to drag himself away from his artist studio to join us. No sign of Henry, of course. He's far too busy with the business. Opposite Walter and Alf are my little sisters, Alice and Olive. Alice has her nose in a book as always, and Olive's flyaway hairs and what appears to be gravy down her dress belie the fact she is actually a very accomplished nurse. Mum asks what was so important that I am late for dinner. The fight for women's suffrage is the most important of our age. The Women's Social and Political Union is at the forefront of that, and Evelyn and I are proud to be a part of it. I am not going to stop now. Walter calls us hysterical, and Mav asks again why I was late. We've been smashing windows on the Strand. I've never heard my family so quiet. I braced myself for Mav's inevitable explosion. But it's not Mav. It's Fav. Fav, I thought you supported the cause. Why must everything always come back to this? I wish you would stop treating me like I'm a... Fav who says the word out loud. Invalid. He says, sorry, but I am one, and I must accept that. arrested and sentenced to 1 month's hard labour. The prison guards' faces were priceless. I don't know why Fav was so worried about my treatment here. I have in fact been better treated here than I often am on protests. At least here, the police won't throw me out of my tricycle. And being imprisoned with Evelyn and the other women has been a great comfort. I'm home! Well, I didn't expect a great welcome home, but I didn't expect everyone to be so quiet. My imprisonment must have taken a greater toll on them than I had thought. 6th November. The wedding is next week. That Fav is unwell. Of course, everyone is overreacting. Fav will be fine. He will be fine. We just need to keep up that Billinghurst spirit. Speaking of spirit, Walter, why don't you go to the cellar and get some of that Bermuda rum? Fav calls from upstairs and... I can't do anything except upset Muv. So, I just sit here, being quiet. He wants to talk to me. Why me? I haven't been upstairs in years. I don't need your help, Walter. That came out sharper than I intended. I can manage on my own. So fragile, like he's made of paper. I should have sneaked up a bottle of Bermuda rum. That was a lovely trip. I wish we could have stayed for longer. The others were so jealous. You took only me. And Marv didn't want you to take any of us. Marv is the one who wanted me to go. You just need to focus on getting better for the wedding. He wishes he had seen me in love. Don't go upstairs again. You were in the pub with Alf. doctor declares he's going back to Shanghai. Next week. With Evelyn. Well, I'm going to the union tomorrow. And I don't care a jot what anybody thinks of me. I can't just sit here doing nothing. I have to keep busy. And Fav supported what I was doing. He wanted me to keep doing it. Who's that at the door? Of course. Evelyn. Walter reminds me as he leaves that Evelyn is his fiancée and is going to be his wife, and that I had better accept that. Absolutely freezing. My cover, if anyone asks, is that I'm taking a stroll around the common for my health. My actual doctor would be appalled if he knew I was spending 2 hours outside in the cold night, but that is neither here nor there. Our plan is a simple one. I am to take the tubes of ink, give them to my colleague, and she is to place them in the postbox. We have timed it so the damage will not be too great, but enough to cause a stir. Then, two colleagues will report us to the nearest police officer. Damage like this is not new, but it has never caused the reaction in the press we would have hoped for. Yet, if someone is caught doing it, a cripple, no less, they will have to take notice. want you to understand that the motive with which, that it is not with the motive of wanton destruction that women attack property. The motive is to wake the public of its apathy to this grievous injustice against women. We women have tried every method. The quiet, constitutional method was tried for more than 40 years. It was not until we became militant 7 years ago that the public was aroused to think, and it was not until we began to damage property that the public were brought pressure to bear on a government which will give way under due pressure. For 7 long years, we women have been imprisoned, have suffered themselves, been near to death's door, and on the hunger strike in prison. And some have lost their lives as a result. It is now time that if the public does not awake, it should be inconvenienced until they understand the urgency of granting women the vote. What is a spoiled envelope's worth compared to the lives lost in the struggle? This is woman's war for freedom. And I want you to understand that in raiding letterboxes, my very great cause is nearing its fulfillment. And I want you to understand, above all, that these agitations, this war, will not stop unless a vote bringing votes to women is brought this session. 8 months. Will I be able to take my tricycle with me to the prison? Don't you understand that I need it? I can't get along in prison without my tricycle. I rebel against imprisonment in any division. The government should be imprisoned, not us.
need to write to the papers. I have to tell them what happened. He pulled my arms back and forced back my head. He forced a tube down my nostril. I think the passage was too small. I coughed and vomited the tube. The doctor used an iron instrument. He broke my tooth. He forced the tube down my throat. Tricycle. She says I'm brave. I need to see the papers. And that my father would be proud of me. Where is my tricycle? She said Alf wrote to the Home Office every day I was in prison, begging for my release. I need to see the papers. And that Walter wrote me a letter. Says he's sorry. And Evelyn sends her love. Where is my tricycle? I need to see the papers!
is not our last battle. It is merely the beginning of the war. It is and will continue to be hard. But we are not alone. Take the hand of the person next to you. Take it. This is your comrade, your ally, your friend. It is together we can keep fighting. There will be suffering. There will be sacrifices. There will be loss. But there are victories. There is friendship. And there is hope.